My next guest attended a classified briefing on North Korea with Secretaries Mattis and Tillerson earlier in the week. Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger, a member of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, with me now. Sir, good morning and welcome back here.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing fine. I know you can't share a lot on that meeting, with that hearing, but characterize it as best you can.
Well, look, there's a lot of concern. We think tomorrow may be a day where they decide to test a new intercontinental ballistic missile because, you know, it's one of the 1,000 holidays in North Korea where his dad rode a unicorn into heaven or something. And so that's going to be tomorrow, we think, potentially. But basically what it comes down to is the North Koreans, they have the technology together. What they need to perfect, which they will at some point, is reentry technology. So what that means to us is that we have to boost up our ability to intercept ICBMs and missiles, which, thanks to President Reagan, we started developing in the 80s, and we now have a decent ability to do it. We need to have a credible military option. Diplomacy doesn't work without a credible military option backing it up. And I give a lot of credit to the administration for being clear that that is on the table, but the hope is that diplomacy works prior.
You also flew Air National Guard in the state of Illinois, too, so you understand this very well. When you talk about reentry, is that the reason why they try to get higher and higher in altitude? With each test?
Yeah, so what basically they can do is they can shoot it way up into space, and you can take that trajectory and actually kind of flatten it and see what the range of that missile is. So once it goes into space, obviously coming back through that atmosphere is a tough thing. How do you keep it from wobbling, losing control, or burning up? But look, even if they don't have the technology to do that today, we've seen they have the ability to come up with that. So I think we're within a very near future them having a fully capable, workable ICBM. So that's why having the defense system is so important. That's why the money that we do out here to build that defense is important. And having a real credible military option, and not one where all the talking heads are on TV saying there's no chance we'll ever use it, it's too devastating. The reality is, yeah, war's messy. We have to have that as an option because that's what makes diplomacy actually work.
With the Emir of Kuwait yesterday, the president was asked about this at the White House and said this about a military possibility.
Military action would certainly be an option. Is it inevitable? Nothing's inevitable. It would be great if something else could be worked out. We would have to look at all of the details, all of the facts, but we've had presidents for 25 years now. They've been talking, and the day after an agreement is reached, new work begins in North Korea, continuation on nuclear.
What's that say to you when you hear that?
Well, it says that we have a president that understands, as President Obama told him when they were in this transition in the Oval Office, this is the challenge of our generation. This is the challenge of his presidency, even beyond terrorism. And we cannot allow the North Korea to have a nuclear weapon. And look, President Trump, some people take issue with his language. Fine, you know, whatever, you can take issue with it. I think it's for the first time somebody talking tough, saying, look, we're willing to use our military to ensure the safety of us and our allies. We hope we don't have to, but rest assured, we will if we need to. That's what makes diplomacy way more likely to act, because they can see that there is an alternative on the table that's unthinkable to everybody.
We'll see what happens this weekend. Thank you, sir, for your time today. Adam Kinzinger.
Anytime.